He is a warrior who is dedicated to peace. He fought in Iraq and is working to bring peace to Kenya. ABC's Mike Lee reports on his story.
Captain Rye Barcott has spent months under stress, like most other U.S. Marines in this war zone.
It's enormously draining when you're outside the wire and under danger, where the enemy really is faceless, and you can be hit really at any time.
But there's been double stress for Rye Barcott. Unlike most American troops in Iraq, he has been fighting two battles in different countries. His other war, a personal campaign he runs by phone when in Iraq, is 2,400 miles away from the Middle East in Africa.
Tuko pamoja.
In between combat assignments in Iraq, his private mission here in this slum in Nairobi, Kenya called Kibera, is to prevent rival African tribes from erupting into sectarian warfare. Tensions between rival tribes had already erupted into riots.
I'm hoping that Kibera doesn't become a situation like Iraq. It doesn't degenerate into ethnic violence.
Rye Barcott first came here as a student from the University of North Carolina and was shocked by what the outside world had largely ignored. 700,000 people on a patch of land the size of New York Central Park in desperate conditions.
It's not right for folks to live like this. We've got to do something about poverty.
Rye Barcott started his own personal foreign policy in the hope that one American could make a difference. He gave up the comforts of his home in North Carolina and moved into the Kibera slum and formed a charity to turn these shacks,
we're going to repave this whole floor,
into a youth center and into a medical clinic. Now Rye Barcott even has rival gangs cleaning the streets together.
Yeah, got some trash here.
And playing soccer. If you want to win, he says, and most kids do, then you have to trust teammates who could be your enemy off the field. When he joined the Marines, Rye Barcott took his war on African poverty with him, raising donations of $10,000 a year.
For me personally, it's enormously gratifying because I'm engaged in two forms of public service.
An American who has served his country in and out of uniform. What advice does he have for other young Americans?
Expose yourself to how the majority of the world lives. And I think it'll make you a lot more appreciative of what you've got. And make you a better American and make you a better global citizen.